Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 15th of February. Indo-Japan partnership has central place in development efforts, says Indian Foreign Minister Jaishankar. Taliban suggests continuation of foreign forces in Afghanistan will favor no one. And poor road infrastructure continues to trouble locals in Gilgit-Baltistan. And now for all the details. Ahead of the upcoming assembly polls in India's northeastern Assam state, Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar and the Ambassador of Japan to India, Satoshi Suzuki, on Monday visited the Japanese-funded water supply project site along the Brahmaputra River and reviewed its progress. Jaishankar on Monday said a closer India-Japan partnership is most natural and has had a central place in India's modernization and development efforts. India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar on Monday said a closer India-Japan partnership is most natural and has had a central place in India's modernization and development efforts. Jaishankar and Japanese Ambassador to India Satoshi Suzuki arrived in northeastern Guwahati city on Sunday for reviewing Indo-Japanese projects being implemented in Assam state. The foreign minister, during an event at the water purification plant, said the economic and strategic emergence of the partnership is expressed in a unique platform on India's Actis Forum.
Japan was the original model for the revival of Asia after Western colonialism. It has long been involved in the expansion of our economic and social infrastructure. Across our states and cities, Japanese official development assistance has funded roads, rail, urbanization, and energy.
Later, speaking at a press meet, Japanese ambassador said the northeastern part of India is situated where India's Actis policy and Japan's vision for a free and open Indo-Pacific converge. He also urged businessmen to choose Assam.
What Japanese government can do is to offer official development assistance. That would create necessary infrastructure, as Minister just said. It is up to Japanese businessmen to choose Assam for their investment.
Jaishankar's visit to Assam comes ahead of the assembly elections in the state. Earlier, Interior Minister Amit Shah and Prime Minister Narendra Modi also visited the poll-bound state. The arrest of 22-year-old Indian climate activist Disha Ravi, accused of sharing an online toolkit of information on the ongoing farmer protest, has sparked an outrage. Indian opposition politicians and activists on Monday condemned the move and slammed the government, with many calling it an attack on free speech.
Indian opposition politicians and activists on Monday condemned the arrest of 22-year-old Indian climate activist Disha Ravi, accused of helping to edit and distribute a toolkit that promoted ongoing farmer protests, which was also later mentioned by Swedish environmental activist Greta Thunberg in a tweet. Disha Ravi has been remanded to 5 days police custody over the charges of being one of the key conspirators in the formulation of the toolkit, which the police said was created with an intention to spread disaffection against the Indian government and create disharmony. Leaders across several political parties condemned her arrest and slammed the government, with many calling it an attack on free speech and a move to silence the voice of the youth.
I think the whole intent of the government is to, through this process, threaten the young in India that if you speak against the government, you will be dealt with in this fashion.
Police have been cracking down on the farmer protests against the new farm laws since thousands of protesters stormed the iconic Red Fort last month on Republic Day. India, which says its reforms are meant to modernize antiquated produce markets, blames vested interests and outsiders for misleading the farmers, as the protests have drawn international support.
In news from Afghanistan, the Taliban has warned of consequences and said that the blame for future incidents if foreign troops don't leave Afghanistan will be on those who want to continue violence and continue a foreign presence in Afghanistan. Giving a message to NATO leaders, the militant group said the continuation of presence of foreign forces in Afghanistan is neither in favor of the international organization nor does it benefit Afghans.
The Taliban, in a message to NATO leaders, has said the continuation of foreign forces' presence in Afghanistan is neither in favor of the international organizations nor does it benefit Afghans. The Taliban has warned of consequences and that the blame for future incidents will be on those who want to continue violence and continue a foreign presence in Afghanistan. This comes as NATO defense ministers are expected to decide on the presence of international forces in Afghanistan soon and whether they will exit based on the May 1 deadline. But Mohammad Amin Ahmadi, an Afghan Republic negotiator who has recently returned from Qatar, where peace talks between the Afghan government and the Taliban were being held, said withdrawal of international troops from Afghanistan in the absence of an agreement on peace will lead to a civil war in the country. This comes as the peace talks in Doha have been stopped for around a month, as both sides have held no meeting at the working group level to discuss the agenda of the negotiations.
More news from Afghanistan. A massive fire at a customs post in Afghanistan close to the Iranian border on Saturday has inflicted hundreds of millions of dollars in financial damage to investors who kept their goods parked at the area. At least 60 people were injured in the explosion at Islam Kala port. The blaze has been contained and an investigation launched into its cause. At least 100 oil and gas tankers have been destroyed by the massive fire at the border town of Islam Kala, 120 kilometers west of Herat city in Afghanistan on Saturday, causing millions of dollars of losses, reports suggest. The catastrophe at Afghanistan's biggest trade crossing with Iran has inflicted hundreds of millions of dollars in financial damage to investors who kept their goods parked at the area and distributed them to other parts of the country once they were cleared through customs. At least 60 people were injured as hundreds of fuel vehicles exploded in a massive blaze on Saturday afternoon.
دیگه میلیارد دلار از مردم خسارمند شده هم از مردم از ملت از دولت هیچی هستن خوشه ای نسخت نخصی به زونه رسیده فقط هم از مردم ملت از تاجر از متردار بسته بسخته کسی به دادی کسی نرسیده هم متردار مردم هم بسخته
According to the finance ministry, the fire was fully extinguished after almost 24 hours on Sunday afternoon. It said a team has been assigned to measure the damages caused by the blaze and the investors who have suffered damage in the fire will be compensated. Meanwhile, investigation into the cause of the fire is underway. Moving on, locals in Yasin Valley of Gilgit-Baltistan have raised concern over the poor condition of roads, which continues to create daily travel problems for them. They blame dilapidated condition of roads has also adversely affected the tourism potential of the illegally occupied region.
Poor condition of roads continue to create daily travel problems for the locals in remote areas of Yasin Valley in the illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan. Locals said the stooge government in the region, which works at Islamabad's behest, has completely neglected the issue and there has been no provision to construct the dilapidated roads. They said hollow promises to fix the roads and improve infrastructure keep coming from the politicians, but that too only at the time of elections.
So here the road condition is very bad. Here the Yasin Kawam ke liye bahut bade masail ke darpesh hai kyunki yahan pe jitne bhi truck aur buses bade gaadiyan jo aati hai unke liye bahut hi masail hota hai aur jo truck gandum bori lekar aate hain unke liye kai dafa yahan pe fas chuke hain.
Gilgit-Baltistan is home to some of the most captivating natural sceneries on earth, which have the potential of making it a tourist hotspot. However, the locals said the sad reality is that the number of tourists flocking the region has also declined to a dismal low due to the poor infrastructure.
Pakistan continues to suffer from the smoke pollution and is the fifth most vulnerable country to climate change. As part of efforts to restore biodiversity and battle a possible ecological disaster, Prime Minister Imran Khan's government has decided to rev up efforts and recently launched countrywide tree plantation drive using a technique developed by a Japanese scientist. Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan has launched a countrywide spring tree plantation drive in urban areas to curb the growing smoke pollution in the country. A day after launching the plantation drive in East Lahore City, Khan on Saturday said it is based on the Miyawaki technique used in Japan. The technique, also known as the potted seedling method, entails planting dozens of native species in the same area, which becomes maintenance-free after 3 years. The South Asian country has launched a slew of projects to tackle climate crisis, including the Billion Tree Honey Initiative to curb the growing smog pollution. Moving on to news from Nepal. Anger has mounted amongst women in Nepal against rising cases of violence against them and a proposed law that would restrict foreign travel for them. Hundreds of rights activists and members of civil society held a massive march in capital Kathmandu recently against the proposed regulation and demanded an end to politics over their rights.
Anger has mounted in Nepal against government's failure to control the rising cases of crimes against women. Hundreds of women rights activists and members of civil society held a massive march in parts of capital Kathmandu last Friday to call for end to violence and discrimination against women and the scrapping of a proposed law that would restrict travel for many women. The protesters raised concern over the proposed law that would require women under 40 years of age to get permission from their family and local government to travel to the Middle East or Africa. The government has argued the proposed regulation would help stop human trafficking and is aimed at protecting women. The protesters tried to march to the Prime Minister's office but were blocked by riot police.
गाउँ गाउँ देखि हामी भन्दै आइरहेको छ गाउँ गाउँ देखि कराइरहेको छ तर केही फरक पर्दैन सिंह दरबारलाई फरक पर्दैन बालुवाटारलाई फरक पर्दैन तर फरक कोलाई पर्छ तपाई हामीलाई मात्र पर्छ
Cases of violence against women including rape and sexual misconduct has remained high In the last 2.5 years, a total of 5,635 cases of rape have been lodged, the records from police headquarters have shown.
In the far north of India, Ladakh has created artificial glaciers to combat the water crisis in the cold and dry hilly region, especially during winter. The artificial glaciers, ice stupas, are one of the most popular forms of conserving winter wastewater in high altitude areas and are an effective tool to deal with adverse impacts of climate change in the ecologically fragile area.
India's Himalayan coal desert of Ladakh has created ice stupas or artificial glaciers to combat the water crisis in the cold and dry hilly region, especially during winter. Ice stupas are one of the most popular forms of conserving winter wastewater in high altitude areas and are an effective tool to deal with adverse impacts of climate change in the ecologically fragile area. Over the past few winter, environmental engineer Sonam Wangsuk has been creating these ice cone structures by running pipes under the frost line or the freezing depth and then pushing water through these pipes into cold air, which causes it to land as ice on the ground.
Ice stupa, जो कि एक कृत्रिम ग्लेशियर मानव निर्मित आर्टिफिशियल ग्लेशियर का रूप है उसके जरिए से जो सर्दियों में पानी बहती है चश्मों से जो कि ज़ाया हो जाती है क्योंकि कोई सर्दियों में खेती होती नहीं है उसको जमा कर रखने का काम कर रहे हैं ताकि जब बसंत में वो बीज बोएंगे तब उन्हें ये पानी पिघलता हुआ मिले और कुछ उन्हें लाभ हो
The snowfall during winter in the Himalayan regions form natural glaciers on the higher reaches of the mountains, which melt away slowly during summer. The melted water is then used for irrigation and drinking purposes throughout the year. But due to climate change in recent years, the shrinking glaciers are forcing people to look for alternative ways of conserving water during winter.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.